Who's the big bad this season?
We definitely have a couple of new villains. You meet them in season in episode two.
So that's all
I can say about it. Yeah.
Is it a group or is it an individual?
That's all I can say.
Can you tell us about that time jump that we saw at the end?
Yeah, our villains for this season are intimately tied up with that those flash forwards. And in the first episode, the Luke tribute episode, we didn't do any flash forwards or anything like that. But the flash forwards start coming fast and furious in episode two.
And will that come to fruition this season or this?
Definitely this season.
Okay.
Yeah.
And can you just tell us a little bit about how Luke's passing has affected the narrative?
Yeah, you know, I think the character most affected is Archie, and you know, I think the biggest thing is that Archie, like all the kids, but is growing up a lot this year, and there's a melancholy kind of shadow over everything Archie does. His father was a great man, and he's, you know, trying his best to live up to kind of these ideals that Fred represented about helping the town, helping his friends, being selfless, being responsible. So I think Archie's really struggling with that ideas of being a good person and doing good in Riverdale.
What can you say about the new students that'll be introduced in the prep school that Jughead's going to?
They're snooty. they're private school kids. I think they're fun characters. They all sort of belong to a literary society, so they're very pretentious, and I think Jughead has a real deep well of knowledge. And is kind of always the smartest guy in the room, and I think in this room he's kind of meeting his match.
Right.
Yeah.
I love that you get in references to like Dorian Gray and Gossamer, just words like that. How can you just tell me about writing that and not dumbing things down for the audience? Maybe challenging kids to things up.
Yeah, you know, that's something that we did from the pilot. I'll never forget. You know, when you do a pilot, you do a test screening. You like show it in some town, and people come in and they see the show. And in the pilot, Veronica says, "Oh, you know, this town is you know, like I'm Truman Capote, Breakfast at Tiffany's." And then afterwards when we met with the people and they were talking about it, they were like, "Why does Veronica say so many make weird references to like Francis Ford Coppola?" And I was like, okay, well, it was Truman Capote. That's always just been. I mean, you know, it's not a naturalistic show. It's a very heightened show. The dialogue is very, very heightened. So we kind of write to that.
But the kids are smart. They're
Yeah, for sure.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
To see you.
But every so often, Cammy says, "Who are these people?"
Speaking of the writing, I'm a big fan of your comic book writing, and I'm curious, in terms of the source material, at this far into the show's run, do you ever dive back into the comics for inspiration?
Yeah, definitely. Archie sends us a box of Double Digests and comics every month. Yeah, we are open against getting stories from anywhere. Every time I get on a plane, I have a Double Digest, and I flip through it or I read stories, partly just because they're so fun, and then partly to see if there's any story we can use. Great. Yeah, definitely.
Can you tell us a bit about Veronica's new sister and her relationship with her family and why we haven't heard about her before now?
Yeah, she's a secret daughter. She's been living sort of a parallel existence in Miami, sort of doing what Veronica has been doing in Riverdale. She's been doing in Miami, running Hiram's clubs. One thing we haven't played with Veronica is sibling rivalry. So we're going to get some of that. Veronica through it all has always thought she's been the apple of Hiram's eye, you know, daddy's girl. And in this season, she's going to meet someone else who has also been thought of herself as the apple of her father's eye, daddy's girl. So it's really, really fun. Their scenes are great. And we meet her in episode 5.
How much of this season do we see, like, the courtroom battle and that kind of stuff?
You know, we it felt like coming out of season three, we had sort of two big storylines to answer. One was the farm, and one was sort of Hiram and Hermione in jail. So in episode three, we have it's a big farm episode, and episode five is our big sort of trial episode, where those storylines are resolved.
Is there going to be a crossover between Riverdale and Katie Keene?
Yeah, well, hopefully. I think it's more likely that Riverdale characters will go to Katie Keene and be 5 years in the future, but I hope so.
That sounds good.
Yeah.
Half-Life with Archie, by the way.
Yeah.
Favorite.
I know. I got to finish it. I know. I know. I will. I will. I will.
Love it so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.